Hello, it's Jang here with a look at a classic Lego space set from 1986. This was called Sonic Robot. It came with 103 pieces, and this one does have the 9-volt lights and sounds system embedded into it. Comes with those two minifigs you see on the front. The arms are highly poseable because you can turn them up and you can fold them in all kinds of ways with the ways that these arms are set up. With so many segments, you can almost reach down to the ground. Not quite though. And they also give you the option to swap out the little grabber hands that they have at the ends here. You could just take that entire piece off, take a piece off the back where you can kind of store these extra pieces and turn that into a shovel. So you can use it for picking up samples for wherever you're exploring out in the vast world of space. Of course, like this, this doesn't really attach to the back very well the way that the shovel pieces did, but it's nice to have one of each just active. And let's see, what else? This entire body piece, the reason it's so rectangular is that is the battery box. That's all one assembly. So that's got a 9-volt battery inside of it. And you see a bunch of trans-colored pieces. This is interesting. This is actually an upside-down head. The entire head assembly is done upside down, and that's just something that wasn't common to see at all back in the days, you know, as such a prominent feature. They would do things upside down from time to time, but to see something that's just so obvious and right out there in front of everything is interesting. So this is an inverted printed tile piece, printed slope piece there. And what else? Well, these are all just regular trans pieces, you know, trans red, trans green, but this is actually a light. So you see the gray, that is your on-off switch for the battery box. And now I've got this thing on. It has one single light on it, and it is the Sonic robot, so naturally it has the sounds, and you can swap the sounds by turning this knob in the center. Now down below, this green piece that I included here is actually just a lens cover for the light. So you can take that off. You see the light is just a regular tungsten little filament in there, but you can take off the red piece, put this green one on instead if you wanted to have a green light. And you could kind of use that in modern terms to simulate rampancy, you know, where the robot goes from good to bad, or you can kind of switch it back and forth, or you can just use it for decorative purposes. But you can only have one light going because they only included one light with the set. You can swap this around though, turn it around and connect it, and then it's not going to blink. That's a cool little feature of that whole system. And then finally, you've got two arrows pointing down. There's always a reason for that. That always means there's something that you can do there. In this case, these two sections come off, and each one of these is just a little flyer that you can use independently with your figures. So there are the two figures that I got with this set. You can see that they're both slightly worn, but not too bad. However, the one on the right has the helmet that's a little bit too old. By now, all the helmets would have been shaped like this with a stronger chin strap in the front. But other than that, these are pretty accurate and in pretty good condition, I would say, especially the faces, nice strong faces on both of them. And there they are on their little scout flyer boards, so you can just pick those up and just fly around with them. They kind of look cool as a team to have them in tandem, or you can have a little race between the two. And you can also attach those back to the robot with the minifigs still in place, so that now the minifigs are controlling the robot. You can have one of them controlling one arm and one controlling the other arm, or one can be controlling both arms while the other one controls the movement. It's got the little engines on the bottom. So this is not a walking robot. It's the type of thing that would kind of hover and then just kind of, you know, just hover across the surface and just kind of scoot along like that. So that's it for this set. However, I did get lucky enough to receive the original instruction sheet that came with the set. So you can see the original art there. And this shows an alternate build, turning it into more of a ship, but it still has the arms on it, so it's still able to grab stuff. I like that idea. Anything else on the back? Sure enough, I think that's a slightly different build, or is that the, yeah, that is a different build. This one is a different one from the front. Another different way to do it. So now this would definitely be your pilot, and this guy would be handling the arms. And one final way of looking at it, you can see it's just going to be hovering, and I like how they pictured it kind of angling forward just a little bit. It really gives some extra life to the thing. I can really see this thing being used. So that's it for my look at this set. I think this was a really smart thing for LEGO to put out on the market during these years when robotics was still something that was extra super cool for a lot of kids. It's kind of coming back in recent years, but it had a real drought there for a while. I feel like through the 90s, kids weren't into robotics much at all. But this was a good way to combine the idea of practical robotics with the LEGO system and bringing in a little extra something with the lights and sounds. I do wish that it had come with two light bases, so you could use both of those lenses at the same time. I think that would have made this even more exciting, but that was surely a budgetary consideration there. Overall, for what it is, I think that it's pretty good. You know, it's a little bit awkward to think of it being a real thing, but as a toy, I think it's really good. Let me know if you have any thoughts of your own about this. Feel free to leave a comment on the video. I've got a lot more videos to bring you, so I'll be talking to you again very soon. Thanks for watching.